Well, Mr. Blatter officially announced that he had changed his mind regarding not running again. He committed, he confessed that a few years ago he really said that it would have been his last term. But he said, okay, I changed my mind. So I took that as an official confirmation that he will run. So I took the floor and I told him that this was not a personal attack, because I respect him. I know him a little bit personal, as in, I like him as a person. But the FIFA has a executive president, and an executive president means that you are responsible. You have the final responsibility for what is happening in FIFA. I think FIFA will come to a standstill, because I also told him, and that is my true opinion, that people don't really take him serious anymore. Because now a few months ago he all of a sudden said the voting for Qatar was a mistake. That means that he blames all the others. Yesterday or the day before yesterday, he linked racism to the vote. How can you do that? I mean, there are other examples of things he said that I wouldn't have said if I was him, and that people don't expect from the FIFA president to say.
My personal view, he should have stayed, you know, with his comment back in 2011. I think he has done some good work over the years. Yes, he's looking at the governance structures and what needs to be done going forward. But in my opinion, governance structures, you know, need the proper people within them. You can change the structure, but unless you have, you know, the right people within it, the structures are irrelevant to me. It's about the people, what the sort of approach is, what the sort of analysis is, and how they're going to take it going forward. So, in answer to the question, I think there is time for a full open debate. What we need for FIFA. FIFA is the overarching body in world football and needs to be have a good relationship with all the confederations.